Judge, the defense calls Nick Miu.
Mr. Miu, please stand. Raise your right hand. The clerk will administer the oath.
Do you swear that the testimony you are about to give in this matter shall be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
I do.
Please have a seat in the witness chair. Mr. Nelson.
You're the Nick Miu we've been talking about for the past 7 days?
Yes, sir.
Nick, I want to right away talk to you about exhibit number 104, if I could have the screen. You were on the Apple River on July 30th?
Yes.
I want to ask you about this exhibit, which says it's from frame 2592 at 149 into the video. Have you seen this before?
Yes.
Do you remember that time in your life when you were on the river in that position as shown in that photograph?
Yes.
Sometime after that, did something happen to you?
Yes.
Were you punched?
Not before that.
After this, were you punched?
After that, yes.
Okay. I want to talk about the time between this and the time that you get punched, okay?
Okay.
Exhibit number 104 there is on the, with it. Where are you on that?
I'm standing in front of two ladies.
In which, if you were going to just describe the symbol on exhibit 104 symbolizing you, which one is that?
The one with the M.
Okay. What color?
Do you want the annotator?
At that point in time, you said there's two people in front of you. Who are those two people in front of you?
A blonde lady to my left and a red hair lady to my right.
Were there other, does this accurately reflect how you remember roughly people in general around you?
Yes.
The blonde lady in front and the other woman, you understand now that through the trial that the blonde woman is named Madison Cohen?
Yes.
Can we use her name when possible?
Yes.
And the you said red-haired woman, her name's Riley Madison. Can we use her name when possible?
Yes.
Possible? So when Riley and Madison are standing in front of you at that point, just before you get punched, right, what are they doing?
They're yelling at me. At one point, they were pointing downriver and saying, go, get away.
What are they doing with their hands?
They're touching me.
When you say touching you, is that something gentle?
No, they're pushing. Madison, she pushed against my left shoulder. She pushed against my chest. She was pointing her finger right at my face. She was yelling at me, very close to my face. Riley had her left, had one of her arms, I believe it was left hand, on my right arm, squeezing and pushing me back.
And you, when you just gave that description, you put your hands a distance apart. Can you show us that again? How far away were they?
About a foot.
Okay.
Less than a foot.
Something. You've heard it described through trial as in your personal space. Would you agree with that?
Yes, right in my face, I would describe.
When that was happening, what did it sound like to you?
The volume was very, very high.
Let me ask you about how your body was responding in that moment when people are pushing you, poking at you, the volume is high. How's your heart? Could you tell us about what your heart rate was?
Oh, yeah. My heart rate was getting really high. My breathing was getting very high. I was...
How about your vision? Did you have normal vision in that moment?
No. At that moment, because of the situation, I was getting tunnel vision.
And can you describe what you mean by you say in tunnel vision?
I couldn't see peripheral vision, but I could see center in right before my eyes.
How about hearing? Could you hear the noises?
I could hear the volume very high, but I couldn't understand what they were saying. The noise became garbled. I mean, the sound became garbled.
Did you feel threatened at that point?
Yes.
Did you have your knife in your right hand?
Yes.
What did you do with your left hand? Tell us what you did with your left hand.
With my left hand, I pushed her away from my face.
Can you show us what you did with your left hand? Why'd you do that?
She was very close to my face. She was in my personal space. She had been there for a while, and I felt threatened.
Did you intend to harm her in some way?
No.
Did you try to harm her in some way?
Absolutely not.
Do you know where, if at all, you had contact with her body when you raised your left hand in that manner?
No.
Do you think you had contact with her?
No.
Okay. I want to take us out of that space now for a second, okay, Nick?
Okay.
If I could have the screen again. You were here in court when we talked about, when we watched the video of you speaking with Brandy Hart, is that right?
Yes.
And I think you told her about your health condition. Can you just tell the jury now, what was your health like on July 30th of 2022?
It was very poor. Okay. Yeah.
Had quadruple bypass surgery before?
Yes, sir.
And when did you have that?
2020, about the same month, so about August.
Showing you here what's been marked as exhibit number 108, can you tell us what those are pictures of, starting just on the left?
Yep, on the left it's me right after the surgery, holding a red heart pillow against my surgery.
What was the purpose that you knew for that red heart pillow?
That was to protect my surgery from hits, bumps.
Was that something that the hospital provided? It looks like there's like almost a picture of heart and lungs on there.
It is. The hospital provided that.
And then the picture in the middle, what is that?
My first walk. My new life.
Did it take you some time to recover and be as active and mobile as you were before?
Oh, yeah.
Do you think you ever reach the same level of mobility and fitness that you were prior to the quadruple bypass?
Never.
What's the picture of you on the right there? You can tell us.
My baby.
Okay. Is that a dog?
Yeah.
Is that dog important to you?
My angel.
Okay. And that's the cushions helping you to enjoy time with her, but still keeping your chest safe?
Yes, sir.
Okay. You've had other surgeries in the past, is that right?
Yes.
Did you have a hernia surgery?
Two hernia surgeries.
Have you had back surgery?
Yes.
And again, in general, would you consider your fitness, if you were going to put it on a scale for July 30th, what would you consider your overall health and fitness on July 30th of 2022?
With my weight, and very poor.
I want to ask you now about moving on to the Apple River on July 30th, okay?
Okay.
On that, this was a planned trip, is that right?
Yes.
Did you get a call from your friend Ernesto sometime before that trip?
Yes, sir.
What was that call about?
He wanted to remind me to bring my knife to cut string when we tied the tubes together.
Okay. When you say, do you have a pocket knife?
Yes.
Okay. Can you tell us about that pocket knife?
I owned it for about 10 years. I have it a lot on me. I use it as a basically a dual tool. I call it my Swiss Army knife, basically because I use it as a screwdriver. I cut insulation when I do electrical work. I use it pretty much everywhere.
Okay.
I'm an engineer. My tool.
Is it something that you've carried on your person, I don't want to say all the time, but somewhat routinely?
Yeah, when I knew I was going to work on something or need it for something, yes.
Okay. Now I want to skip ahead again now to the river, okay? At some point, did Ariel lose his phone?
Yes, he did.
Did you go to look for that phone?
I volunteered to go look for it.
When you went to go look for that phone, what were you wearing?
Before that?
Nope, right when you left your group to go look for that phone, what were you wearing?
So I took my goggles, my snorkel, and my swimming trunks.
Did you have anything on your feet?
Yes, I had on my feet. I had a pair of really, really torn up sandals.
Can I approach, Judge?
Yes.
Showing you what's been marked as Exhibit 113. Is this a packet of 9 photos of your sandals?
Yes.
You've seen those?
Yes.
Does that accurately show the condition of the sandals that you had?
Yes.
Can you just move the admission of Exhibit 113?
Any objection?
I don't think I've seen them, Judge, if I could take a look at it.
Yes.
Oh, pardon, never mind, Mr. Anderson. I've seen them.
Okay. All right, 113 is received.
These weren't taken by you, were they?
Pictures, no.
These were taken by the Sheriff's Department, correct?
Yes.
Permission to publish, Judge?
Yes.
Can I just, because we're going to go through the PowerPoint, can I?
Yeah, just them? Pass them to the jury.
Can you use your words? I know we have a picture that better does it, but just briefly, describe the condition of those sandals.
Horrible.
Okay.
They were just coming apart. I couldn't walk on them unless I tried to mend them.
Okay.
As you can see, I used leftover string to mend them.
When you left wearing those sandals and your shorts, did you have your pocket knife with you?
Yes.
Where was it?
In my right pocket, clipped to my...
Did you have that there pretty much all day?
Yes.
You were here when we watched the video of your interview with Brandy Hart, is that right?
Yes.
When you spoke with Brandy Hart, were you truthful to her about the knife?
No. I lied about the knife.
Was that your knife?
Yes, it is. It was.
Did you bring it with you when you went to go... look for the phone?
Yes, I did.
When you went to go look for the phone, did you have any intent to harm anybody?
No.
Why'd you go leave your group?
To go look for the phone.
Okay. At some point, did you have some contact with a group of teenagers?
Yes.
And you were here in court when we saw the 9-second video, is that right?
Yes.
I want to show you just a couple of slides from that, if I could. Do you see those slides up there?
Yes.
Are those from that video?
Yes.
What are you doing in those 3 slides in general?
I was scanning the water, looking for the phone.
Okay. And are you in that position, are you walking upriver or downriver?
Upriver. Away from that group of boys.
Did you hear them say some things to you?
Yes.
Prior to your walking upriver and them, did you hear those words that I have written on that slide?
Yes.
Prior to your hearing those words when you were walking upriver, had you had verbal contact with that group?
I think so. They asked me what I was looking for, and I told them I'm looking for a phone, a lost phone.
Did you ever tell them that you were looking for little girls?
No.
Were you looking for little girls?
Absolutely not. It's pathetic.
When you, at the end of this, when you watch the video, at the end of the video, where I'm not going to play it, but do you remember what you did right there at the end?
At the end, I was walking away.
Okay. Did you eventually turn around and face in the direction of the group that was yelling at you and calling you a raper?
Yes.
When you...
Yes. I'll sustain the objection. The question was leading. Please continue.
What did you do at the end of the video?
I was walking away.
At some point, did you ever become in a position where you were looking at that group of teenagers that had yelled at you?
Yes.
What did you see when you were looking at that group of teenagers after the end of this video?
I saw one of them holding a phone in a bag, and I believed it was what I was looking for, so I turned around and I started approaching them.
Why did you approach them?
I wanted to get a closer look at the phone to see if it was the one that was that belonged to Ariel.
Did you eventually get near them?
Yes, I started walking, then I rushed the pace, stumbled, and fell on my knees, held on to their tube, at which point I lost my goggle and snorkel kit in the water.
You saw in the video, you saw during your interview with Brandy Hart that you said things different than what you just said now about what happened to your snorkel and goggles.
Mm-hmm.
Is that right?
Yes.
Is your memory sometimes different than what you see in the video?
Yes.
Okay. Was your memory, in your memory, what happened to your goggles?
In my memory, the goggles got
knocked away.
Objection, yeah.
Leading.
So
one second. When there's an objection, just wait on your answer. It is leading, sustained. Next question, please.
His answer was stricken.
It's a leading question. Let's move on.
Is your memory perfect?
Never.
Now that you've watched the video, do you realize that you were wrong about that?
Yes.
What happened to your goggles?
My goggles fell in the water.
When they fell in the water, what did you do?
I started looking for them, searching right where they fell.
It's on already. Showing you here some slides, 220, 225, and 279. Can you tell us what you're doing?
I'm searching for the goggle kit.
And where are you in relation to the six teenagers' tubes? Are you on the side? Are you upriver? Are you downriver? Are you in some other position?
I'm upriver. So, yeah.
I'm going to then show you another group of slides, 575, 600, and 625. What does that show you doing?
All right, so what I did from that point, I went around the inner tubes to the other side, and I continued looking for the goggle and snorkel set.
Why did you walk around from the one side to get to the other side of the tubes?
I thought that the water current would bring him over to the other side, and I was walking away from the boys at the same time.
Okay. During that time that you walked in that direction, did you have any physical contact with them?
No.
Were you confronting them?
No. Didn't say a word.
This next set of slides, what does this show you doing here?
I'm walking away from the group. Still,
why? Go ahead.
I'm still looking for my goggles at that time.
When you were doing that, did you ever hear the kids say anything?
They gave me a warning.
What'd they say?
You got 10 seconds.
In response to that, what did you do?
I ignored them, and I actually continued doing what I was doing.
Okay. I can show you the next set of slides here. Were you in a position to see here 963, 1140, and 1155, what the teenagers were doing behind you?
They were getting closer and closer to me. They were walking towards me.
Were you in a position to see that? Was that behind you, or had you turned around?
I could hear their voices. I could hear that they were getting closer. At some point, I may have turned my head and witnessed that. They're coming towards me.
showing you 1170, 1213, and 1284. What's happening here?
I'm at an angle to them, but I could say I have my back at them. Still scanning the water, and they were right behind me. They got that close. Within seconds, they were right behind me.
At some point, did you see other people from another group?
Yes.
What did you see?
I saw what I seemed to me at the time, adults coming over from the other side of the river.
And when you saw adults coming over from the other side of the river, what did you do?
I walked towards them. I walked towards this. The first one was Madison.
When you walked towards Madison, where were the six teenage boys that had been yelling at you?
They're following me.
Okay. Were you in their path as you walked across the river towards Madison?
No.
Did they have as far as you know, did they have a clear path down the river if they wanted?
More than plenty.
Can I? Showing you this next group of photos, what's going on here?
So in this frame here, the first adult that came to me was Madison. She already had her finger pointing downriver and yelling at me and used some awkward words, ordering me to go down.
We see it looks like you're doing something with your right hand. Do you remember? What are you doing with your right hand?
Yep, I was trying to explain to her what I'm looking for.
When you tried to explain to her what you were looking for, did you get the impression she was listening to you?
No, her voice was too loud.
Actually, that's what Madison had as an impression.
Okay.
Hold on, wait a second. Sustained speculation.
I'm asking about his impression, so I'll rephrase. Did you get the impression that Madison Cohen was going to listen to your words?
No.
Why not?
Because she was too loud. She never stopped to give me a chance to talk, and she kept pointing and ordering me to go downriver.
We've all heard the tape, but was she using polite language?
Polite? No.
Did you hear anyone saying anything behind you when you walked over to Madison Cohen?
Yes, they're all calling me names.
Okay. Showing you the next set of slides here, 1776, 1840, and 1824. What are you doing here in this set of slides?
I'm turning my back towards Madison and the rest of the people.
Why did you turn your back to Madison and the rest of the people?
It felt to me like I couldn't have a conversation with her at that point. She was not listening. And I didn't want to interact any further.
Had you at that point found your snorkel or goggles?
No.
Had you at that point found the phone?
No.
Did you hear anybody saying anything while you stood there with their back to them?
Oh, yeah.
What did you hear?
They were still yelling, he's looking for little girls.
Were you looking for little girls?
Absolutely not.
When you heard them, did you consider that to be a lie?
Objection, Your Honor. Leading.
Sustained.
I asked, did you consider that to be a lie? I
don't. Yes, of course.
Hold on, please.
I don't think that's
leading. I sustain the objection. Please move on.
When you heard that, did you consider it to be truthful or did you consider it to be untrue?
Untrue.
And when you heard someone say an untruth about you, did that change how you were feeling?
I felt frustrated. I felt annoyed. They kept saying it over and over, so it annoyed me and frustrated me.
And when you heard them say this untruth about you, did it appear to you as if the other group that had come over agreed with what these the teenagers were yelling about you?
Objection, leading.
Sustained.
Did you think anybody in the other group was going to help you or listen to you when you were being called these names and accused of being a pedophile?
Objection, leading.
Sustained.
How did you feel?
Well, I felt overwhelmed at that point. I felt still annoyed, frustrated. I felt like she wasn't listening. She was the adult I thought I was going to reason with or get help from. She didn't even attempt to reprimand the children from yelling.
Showing you another slide here, some 1838, 1846, and 1865. Is that you?
Yes.
What are you doing?
Judge, can we approach?
Yes. Just one moment. Ready?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Let's continue.
Showing you photos 1838, 1846, 1865. What are you doing in those? Do you remember what you were doing?
Yeah, I had my back towards the group of people.
In the two photos there, which direction are you looking?
I'm looking downriver.
Are you looking at, there's two different groups, if I recall, from exhibit 104. Is that right?
Yes.
One came from one side of the river and the other one's on the other side of the river.
Correct.
Where are you, in the photo on the upper left, are you looking at one particular group as opposed to another group?
Yes, I'm looking at the boys group.
And why are you looking at the boys group?
Because they were yelling at me.
And what were they yelling at you?
They were yelling things that were not true and pointing at me.
After that happened, showing you the next group of slides, 1875, 1883, and 1889, do you remember what Madison did, if anything, to you?
Yeah.
What did she do?
She grabbed my right arm, and she pulled me towards her, and I lost my balance, so I moved towards her.
Did you consider that, in that circumstance, to be a gentle or a gracious touch?
No. That was not a gracious touch. No, not at all.
Had she been using any gentle or gracious words with you?
Not that I remember.
In those photos, can we see the footwear that you were wearing on that day?
Yep, those sandals that we saw earlier.
Did you have confidence in your footing in that area with those sandals?
Objection, leading.
Sustained.
How did you feel about your footing in that area?
Very unstable.
Want to show you the next set of slides here. Do you remember what you say to Madison after she pulled on your right arm?
Yeah, I told her not to touch me.
And why did you tell her that?
Because she pulled on me without my invitation.
Did you say that in any particular tone?
No, not in a mean tone, but I made it sound so she could hear me. Don't touch me.
Okay. Why didn't you want her to touch you?
I didn't give her permission to do so.
Sure, but why did you not want to give her permission to do so?
Because she was one track mind. She just wanted to get me away from that, point me down river and tell me to go there.
What's your comfort level at this point?
on a scale from 1 to 10, comfort level is very low.
Okay. Are you, if you had that same thing, a scale of like a fear scale, a 1 to 10 fear scale, right? And
yeah.
So with 10 being the most fearful you've ever been in your life and zero, let's call 0 to 10 being the most safe you've ever felt.
Mm-hmm.
Where are you at here on a fear scale?
In that particular?
Yeah.
About 1.
Okay. So you're more uncomfortable, but not necessarily afraid. Is that what I understand?
Correct.
At where was your group in relation to you then?
Was upriver.
And did you do anything in order in relation to your group?
Yep.
What did you do?
I turned to them and I called them. I was trying to call them to come over and help me.
Are these slides, does this 2127, 2140, 2131, what does that show you doing?
I was waving at them and calling them to come over.
When you say you were calling them, did you do something physical or did you something verbal or did you do both?
Physical.
Did you make any verbal comments at that point?
No.
Why not?
It was very loud. All around me was very loud. I don't think that anybody could have heard me 100 and some feet away.
With everybody else yelling, did you think your yelling was going to de-escalate or escalate the situation?
When everybody's raising their voice, I don't think having another raised voice would help the situation.
After you raised your hand to call for your friends, did you see Madison Cohn doing anything?
Oh, yeah. She was looking at towards her group, and then she waved to them to come over to her.
Is that what we're seeing here in 2261, 2262, and 2263? What do you see?
Yep, she's calling her group over.
Did you remember when she called her group over, did her group respond?
Yes.
Did they join that?
Yes.
Showing you now these slides, is that what you saw?
Yes.
I think we asked you questions before about Exhibit 104 with you with the blue dot and the other red dots. When you were, were you standing there? Were other people around you?
Yes.
When you were standing there in that moment with the other people around you after you've called your friends once, was that other group, did they appear to be afraid to you?
Afraid from me?
Afraid. Did they appear? When you look at them, do they look like they're in fear?
No, absolutely.
What does it look like to you?
They're all laughing and enjoying themselves.
At whose expense?
At my expense.
And
wait.
Speculation as to what these other...
Sustained. Speculation as to what other people think. Next question.
How did you feel in that moment when they were around you saying those things? Did you think they wanted you to join in their laughter?
No.
Did you want to join in their laughter?
No, absolutely not.
If this fear scale is going, is it staying at 1 or is it moving in a particular direction?
It's creeping up.
showing you another set of slides here, 2328, 2311, 2382. Do you remember, what do you remember about that?
I remember the young boys were yelling, pointing at me, saying things that are not true.
Were you able to see, like in this next slide, this 2429, 2440, 2401, were you able to see as you stood there what everybody was doing? Were you able to scan and see that?
For a brief second, yes. Okay. They were very close. They were really close to me. I could see and hear them.
How about your fear scale there? Where is it? Where is it?
About 2 or 3.
Okay. I see in the one on the right there, you have your hand someplace. Can you tell me what you're doing with your right hand?
Yes, I'm reaching for my pocket knife.
Why?
Because at one point, my fear was getting really high.
Okay.
And I was getting ready to pull it out.
Okay. Do you remember, other than what you've talked about, Madison Cohen pulling you, which we saw, do you remember anybody else touching, pushing, grabbing you in any way?
The two ladies, yeah.
Showing you here what's 2472, 2478, 2481, do you remember what's happening in those photos?
Yes. This one, the lady on my right side, she grabbed my arm, and she was pushing against my arm.
And did that increase your level of comfort or increase your level of fear or something different?
So it decreased my level, the level of comfort and increased my fear.
Do you remember at some point, do you take your knife out of your pocket?
Yes, I do.
Do you know when that is in relation to these slides? Do you have a memory exactly of when that is?
Not exactly, but when they're pushing and poking at me, I remember I pulled it out then.
Okay. Do you remember, did you have it out before you were punched or after you were punched?
Before I was punched.
Okay. Showing you another set of slides here, it looks like do you remember doing something with your left hand?
Yeah, at that moment, I really needed my people to come over and help me, so I was trying to get their attention.
One more slide here. What's happening here in the slide?
Madison is pushing on my left shoulder and basically yelling at me right in my face.
And then on the next slide, we see something in your hand. Is that right?
That's a knife.
Why did you take out your knife at that point?
I was beginning to be afraid.
And what was it about that moment where everybody is that made you so fearful that you took out your knife?
I was surrounded. They were yelling. They had just pushed me. Well, the lady. They squeezed my arm. I mean, it seemed like they were not backing away.
Previously, you turned around. Is that right?
Yes.
Did you feel comfortable turning around in this situation?
No.
Why not?
They're too close to me.
What happened the last time that you turned around?
Nothing good.
Judge, this
is a good place to break.
May as well be.
All right, it's 12 noon. Let's break for lunch.